So good evening once again, students. We are ready for the discussion of the subject called environmental sciences. Today we are going to talk about the important topics that are mainly eco-friendly practices, energy and waste management, and we shall be able to also talk about the concept of sustainable development. Definitely into the quest of sustainability, into the quest of tourism and allied areas. So let us proceed. First of all, if we are talking about the eco-friendly practices or environmental friendly practices, we must understand what all are the eco-friendly practices or environment friendly practices. There are surprising amount of people, businesses and community that would like to do more to conserve and protect our natural resources, but they don't know where to begin with becoming more environment friendly. Understanding that what makes each of these aspects of our world part of the process of changing and conserving our resources and learning how to be more environment friendly. In a layman's word, becoming environment friendly or adopting certain practices in our day-to-day activities or our industrial activities to provide the welcoming steps for the environment in terms of the environmental conservation and protection. So these are the two main areas. If any act, let's say if we talk about tourism, any act of a tourist or tourism industry is going to protect the environment or not going to degrade the environment by their own practices, definitely it will be called as the environmental friendly or eco-friendly practices specifically in pursuance to tourism. Let's say, as we come to know that tourism is a sum total of activities of the tourist at the destination from the origin. So if a tourist is coming to the destination and while his arrival at the destination, nothing in terms of environment have been affected drastically, or habitat, ecosystem, ecology, environment, wildlife, local community and the main resources of that local community have not been disturbed or been respected in such a way they are more sophisticated or more sustainable. So these are certain practices which may be called up as sustainable practices or eco-friendly practices or environmental friendly practices. Let us try to define this. Environment friendly or environmentally friendly, eco-friendly, nature friendly and green are making claims referring to goods and services, laws, guidelines and policies that are inflict reduced, minimal or not harm at all upon ecosystem or the environment. So what is the bottom line here? The bottom line here is any act of human being by the name of any industry, by the name of the day-to-day actions of the mankind onto the planet are not going to inflict or not going to affect the environment, or they are going to reduce or minimum the harm to the ecosystem or the environment. Of course, these are the sum total of practices of a mankind by the name of industrial tendency of a mankind, or the day-to-day human activities by the name of socialization, by the name of environment, or by the name of economy as a whole may be called up as eco-friendly or environment-friendly practices. Now, once we are talking about environment-friendly practices, we need to understand why it is important to be environment friendly. It is important to be the environment friendly because it is the environment bubble which is more important for all of us. It is the environment which is ensuring everything to the planet, or everything what we are taking as the business or business opportunity by the name of tourism or other service areas are almost impossible without the environment. Therefore, it is our environmental rules which is everything fits together for the puzzle. And therefore, it is important. One more way of saying it is, the faster we will create to the entire ecology of living that promotes our sustainability. That means for, as soon as we are going to becoming environment friendly, our practices will definitely give a very varied system to the environment as a whole, and those practices will definitely help out ourselves to bring up the upgradation of the environment and ecosystem. Therefore, it is important. The next step is to begin to learn to make different choices and the personal level that start of change our awareness and consumption of resources. Students, it's very important, or it is a time where we need to talk about our consumption habit, especially to the resources. Our per capita resource sharing may be not very burden until unless we are having non-sustainable practices of sharing this overconsumption and consuming the services and goods for the betterment of oneself. It is definitely injustice to the others, and this is not at all acceptable in the social practices, so as the economical practices, by the way, also in the environmental periphery. Therefore, our personal change or our value system needs to be changed. We need to ensure ourselves aware about our choices of personal level, that we are going to restrict our consumption habits, and we need to enrich the resources by and large. The changes are surprisingly easy to make, that there are more ways than you can imagine to begin a practice that is called conservation. There are 15 ways of becoming more environment friendly. There are certain practices that we need to talk about. Of course, these are the practices which are the sum total of practices of the of an industrial person or the individual human being in general. So let us talk about those practices in general. First is to become more aware about resources. You know what, students, most of the time we are not aware about our resources. Our main resources, which are important or which are the grassroots cause for our lives, are mainly water, soil, minerals, carbon dioxide, oxygen, and there are many other substances which are important, and plants, herbs, etc. So we need to understand the importance of the resources, and therefore our action needs to be pro-resource, not anti-resource, in terms of creating pollutant, garbage, or any such practices which are not being accepted or appreciated by the environment. Next is to develop the practice of conservation. It is up to us how we are going to contribute to our environment or to our environmental friendly practices by the name of practicing conservation. Conservation is a good habit. If we are procuring our present today, definitely our future will be conserved or procured. In terms of conservation, we need to talk about soil conservation, we need to talk about water conservation, we need to talk about the elimination of the pollutant or any sort of compound which may fix with the resources and then degrade their nature. So we need to talk about such conservation which is to be sustainable and which is to be available for the forthcoming generation. Third is the plantation of trees. As much as we are going to grow up the trees, they will secure our future. As per our Vedic parampara or tradition, it has been told one plant is equals to 10 sons. It has been told एक पेड़ 10 पुत्रों के समान है. सो प्लांट्स ट्री और प्लांटिंग ट्री इज अ सिस्टमैटिकल और स्ट्रेटेजिक सॉल्यूशन फॉर सच प्रैक्टिसेस बाय व्हिच द अल्टीमेट एनवायरमेंटल अपग्रेडेशन मे बी इंश्योर्ड. बिकॉज एवरीथिंग थ्रू आउट अ प्रोसेस एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी कम्स इन कंप्लीटेड इन पास्ट सेशंस दैट ट्रीज आर प्लेइंग अ वाइटल रोल, especially to maintain oxygen, especially to maintain the different types of resources for living and to ensure the availability of goodness of oxygen and so many other components which are important for our living. Next is the conserve water. Conservation of water habit is, water is one of the important element onto the planet, and without water we really cannot survive anymore onto the planet. And therefore, to the population of billions of people, we need to restrict our practices, that we need to minimize the uses of the water, and we need to optimize the use in a minimum way. Whether it is the agricultural work, whether it is the work related to industry or household work, we need to conserve water. Change your travel habits. Traveling is one of the important phenomena nowadays. We need to change our travel habits by which we can ensure the sustainability of the environment while procuring the elements. Next is, use less fossil fuel based products. We must encourage our practices to use less fossil fuel based products, and then definitely they will help us to cope up with the less immersion of the carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide or such gases which are harmful for the environment. We need to buy local grown products, especially the products which are eco-friendly and which are being made up by the local community. So this way we are not only going to create the social sustainability, but we are also going to contribute the economical sustainability followed by the environmental sustainability practices. Buy local green products will not have a negative effect on the environment as we are going to have the chemicals one. So we need to reduce use of harmful chemicals. This is the next eco-friendly practice that we need to adopt. We need to encourage ourselves to buy recycled products. Recycled products are those products which are a set of organism by which they can degrade it easily, and the substance may be fixed with the environment very easily without creating any pollution, and then they can be regenerated. Next eco-friendly practice we must need to ensure at our end, that is composting. Composting is a kind of decomposing is the kind of factor that we are talking about. Anything that we are creating that needs to be composite, and compositing is an area where a lot of agrarian are moving towards, and this particular aspect is a proper cycle for the environmental practices, which is not harming to the any cycle of the environmental system or ecosystem. We need to join environmental groups for that. This will be a practice that we can, especially the urban people, can adopt. We need to develop a habit of cleanliness, adopting the cleanliness, or maybe called as stopping littering. The cleanliness habits or personal hygiene and social hygiene needs to be talked about. Wildlife protection needs to be talked about, because our eco-friendly practices or practices those are going to preserve the environment would not interest us until unless we are not talking about the protection of the environment, especially wildlife, flora, fauna and other animal beings. We need to educate others, because education in terms of the environment is the must, and it is the need of hour, so that we can generalize or justify our social responsibility towards the environment. Now, let us move towards the next topic, which is very important topic, energy and waste management. Students, we have, there are two terms to be talked about, energy and waste. And then third term is talked about the energy and waste management. So if we can spare 1 minute here, and then we can talk about what do we understand by energy? And what do we understand by the waste? So first of all, in general, we need to understand energy is certainly a kind of source by which any mechanism can be moved, or the social life can be moved, or certain things can be used as the energy requirements of the mankind. Energy is, in the scientific words, energy cannot be produced, cannot be destroyed, because energy can be only transform from one segment to the another. But it is a scientific explanation. Energy is replicated in the different forms, maybe kinetic energy, maybe static energy, maybe the magnetic energy and solar energy and so on. So we need to adapt certain practices by which we have to minimize our energy consumption. On the contrary, waste is certain thing for a layman's day-to-day act. Everyone is creating certain garbage, litter or the dung, which are none of the more important use, rather they are the waste. So waste is certain thing, is an outcome of certain productivity or certain process which are not meaningful for the use. Now there is a connect in between energy and waste management. What do energy have with the waste? The idea is for energy and waste management to come out with the tons of garbage, because every single human being within 24 hours or a week or a year creating tons of garbage already been produced by the industries, and the simultaneous or ongoing the economic system, social system altogether. Therefore, there is a great amount of talk need for management of such waste or litter or dung or so many things. So the idea is, why not to convert energy? Why not to convert waste into the energy? And that will be the fixation of two problems: the energy requirements or challenges for the major population to come up with the energy sources, and on the contrary, waste management can also be ensured. So the best way of energy and waste management is waste to energy. We need to getting towards the waste to the energy. This is the identical solution. What is waste to energy? We must understand this. Waste to energy refers to a formal family of technological that treats waste to recover energy in form of heat. Identically, if you are a student if you have studied science at a school level, you understand equation E is equals to mc square. E is equals to mc square. That meant for the energy can be created, or any masses can be converted into the energy if it is being traveled by the rays of speed of light and or its square. Well, this is the theoretical explanation. In practical, the mechanism by which waste can be converted into the energy, the same system that we are talking about. So let us quickly have this slide and then we'll move with this topic further. Waste to energy refers to a family of technological that reveals treat waste to recover energy in the form of the heat, electricity or alternative fuels such as biogases. Therefore, the scope of the term waste to energy is very wide. Waste to energy is not a small propagation, and therefore millions of tons or billions of tons of garbage can be converted into the useful energy while adopting the process, or while completion of the different type of social waste by the or the municipal waste, or follow form by the different plants or the technology adoption, so that this can be generalized. These can include the production of cooking gas in household, digesters from organic waste, collection of methane gas and from landfills, thermals, treatment of waste and utility size in increasing plants, co-processing or refuse diversified fuel in cement plants or gasification. So when we are talking about a general example, how do the waste can be converted into the source of energy? The most good example is the biogas. Whenever we are talking about composition, we are pouring the human dung or animal dung into that is called organic waste to a system called plant and processing that is called refuse derived fuel RDF in cemented plant for gasification, and that will create CH4 or called methane, which is a form of liquid petroleum gas, or it is a source of LPG against the biofuel. This guides take a very broad understanding to WTE. We will refer waste to energy, referring to large scale plants of the municipal level, that is utility size, using the technologies in insertion or co-processing, and creating such certain landfills by the help of the laborers or plants, so that gasification can be created and we can use it for the further usage. These five technology applies in different waste stream and have different functions and characteristics. So energy through the waste or waste to energy is an identical answer of energy and waste management. And students, this is the solution of $1 million or $1 billion in terms of the mammoth population of the world and mammoth population requirement for the energy, especially in second or third world countries. Key findings and recommendation: the development of MSWM, that is called the municipal waste management system. Municipal waste we are talking about whenever we are creating garbage as a household. There are two typical type of garbage that we used to discuss recently: geela kachara or sukha kachara, whatever it is. So whenever the MSWM or municipal waste management system should follow these waste hierarchy. Waste reduction through prevention should take on priority. Waste needs to be reduced through the prevention should take priority, followed by preparation of reuse, because reusage is very important phenomena, and the material recycling of the waste, because even the waste can be recycled and then it can be reused. Waste to energy projects can be categorized as a complementary technology for the recovery of energy from the remaining non-recyclable MSW, that is the municipal society's waste fractions, and should therefore not compare with waste reduction, reuse and material recycling measures. These are the essential conditions. Waste to energy must fulfilling high emission standards. Emission standard needs to be very high enough, otherwise the waste cannot be turned up into the energy. As we were talking into the quest of E=mc², though it is very important equation, but not being standardized in these propagation. A comprehensive legal framework for all these types of waste to energy exists in new cases only, where laws are not available or existing one cannot be enforced. The high emission standards required will not be achieved. Low emission standards shall not be tolerated, as they have irreversible health impacts. So in terms of emission standards, we need to talk about. Now we need to understand what is emission standards. Emission standards are those scientific standards set by the scientific scientist or technologist. Once we are converting waste into the energy, then they need to be emit. The waste need to be emit that level where this can turn up into the energy. So these are the levels. This is much in technical, so there is no need to go into depth of that. Waste to energy requires knowledge on waste quantities and characteristics. It is the must. Waste quantities till double in next 20 years in many cities, but consistent waste management plans which consider demographic and social changes are often missing. Students, what we are facing the challenge in terms of energy or waste management, or waste management while converting waste into the energy, there should be the quantification of the characteristic of the waste. We need to understand what is the tendency of our waste. because every waste doesn't have the same characteristics, so that it may not be procured for the such a long time. Otherwise, some or the other way, it may be degraded and may not be have the quality for changing in terms of energy, in terms of considerable demographic and social changes. Waste to energy requires significant financial sources. It's not all about that it is a fixed formula that we can set up. There are certain financial obligations that are also added with it. Most of them are secure finance for operation, and maintenance is a key for sustainable operation of energy and waste management plants. So these are not more of them are in the finance friendly or money friendly, but they are consuming a lot of funds, but they are creating energy. Energy and waste management is, it's a 50-50 scenario. We can understand it is all about the management of waste, and it is all about the management of alternate ways of the energy while creating the transformation of the waste. Now we'll talk about urbanization and new challenges in waste management. We'll quickly talk about that. There are certain databases which are available with us, with the help of PPT. So let us talk about in general in a quick succession. The 21st century will be the century of the cities. Definitely, it is the urban population of the world has grown rapidly since 1950, 746 million to 3.9 billion in 2014. Excuse me. According to UN data, it is expected to increase up to 9.7 billion by 2050, with nearly 90% of the increase to take place in the urban areas of Africa and Asia. Now these are the scenarios in front of us. Ahead of next 30 years, our population would be 9.7 billion. So this will be a mammoth population for this, especially in Asia and South in Africa continent. So we can understand or figure it out how would we deal with the energy requirement of everyone, because as soon as we are getting faster in terms of population, we'll have to think about the alternate sources of the energy. Therefore, already today, the global amount of municipal solid waste are estimated at 2 billion tons per year. Now, it is just, excuse me. Now, it is just not the example of any urban area, but it is an estimated total 2 billion tons per year. It's not a small amount, or it takes a lot of area onto the planet to have a process on that. So this is to justify whether they are going to convert it into the source or not. So it is very important for all of us to ensure what we will or how we will deal with that 2 billion tons per year. Unlike world population and urbanization trends, there are no UN forecasts of future waste propagation per capita, because it is hardly very difficult, or it is hardly an impossible task to gratify these statistics in terms of the per capita waste generation, because it is going to keep up gradually. And once we are talking about keeping it up, it will keep more further, more and more. There is a common understanding that waste quantities will sustainably increase. The drivers are increased consumptions of goods in growing urban population, changes in lifestyle, and increasing wealth are the rise in middle class. There are two, three major reasons for that. One is the urban population or upgradation or growing of the urban population. Second is changes in the lifestyle of the mankind and the increasing wealth of the rising middle class. So once we have talked about the challenges to the urban population for managing waste to energy. Waste to energy, a temptation for municipalities or the Mahanagarpalikas that we call in Hindi. Waste to energy is not a small project. It is just maybe seen identical, but it is challenging. It's not an easy temptation. Dealing with the issue of waste to energy means reaching a new level of complexity in an already challenging waste management solution. Therefore, we need to talk about those challenges. These challenges are typical in nature, and these are not orthodox natures. Nevertheless, waste to energy technologies can improve waste management in fast growing cities and developing and emerging countries, but its application is complex and must consider almost others. The following specific circumstances as they are meant here. Friends, it is not very easy to make the waste convert into the source of energy. Rather, it is more challenging. There are certain challenges in terms of management of garbage, management of plants, management of working professionals, educating them, and then there are certain processes in terms of getting the license from the authorities and so many other institutional requirements in terms of law. So lower calories values of MSW, that is called municipal waste, that in industrialized or industrial countries, due to the high moistures, high organic content and minerals content in waste, that is as construction or demolition waste. There are typical wastes in terms of household or municipal corporation waste, which they used to collect from the household, or the industry waste. So there are two types of typical waste, and these are very important in terms of the fabrication of these the waste into the energy. They are, let me quickly read this particular points. Sustainable season change in waste composition, because it is not only the management of the workforce or management of plants or taking some licensing or permissions, but it is also to deal with the seasons, the festivity seasons and seasons where the temperature conditions are changing, the waste and the tendency of waste in terms of disposal is also being changed. Next is limited practice of waste segregation to source, precondition for the anaerobic digestion. That meant for whenever we are talking about waste segregation practices, there are certain preconditions for having the proper digestion of the waste, because every waste is not prolonged their qualities for so many days. Weak business and operation models are there, especially in this part of the world, especially in Indian subcontinent, because we don't have very good business practices or business ideas for this particular segment. Lack of knowledge of how to operate and maintain waste to energy plants. Even the government organizations, the institutions are not creating a lot of awareness about that. High investment and operating cost, which cannot be recovered by the existing waste fee and generated additional income from energy sales alone. This is the major area where we need to think about. Neglecting of livelihood, issues of migrated persons and informal sector workers, dependence on the availability. So these are certain areas where we need to think a lot. Otherwise, this particular task will be very difficult. Lack of monitoring and weak enforcement of environmental standards, leading to public health issues. So in general, if we can conclude what all are the challenges, first is the dealing with the waste, then the practices of waste segregation is much lesser, weak business system, operation models are not there, we are having lackness of knowledge in operation and maintenance of waste and energy plants. These are high in terms of investment, operating cost, and neglecting in terms of livelihood, and there is a lot of monitoring and enforcement cost and standards in terms of public health. If we talk about waste to energy, let us talk about a diagram. This diagram can help you understand this particular phenomena in a very successive manner. If we talk about materials and parts manufacturers, if we talk about production manufacturer, if we talk about retail and service providers, then we can understand there is one cycle. The collection is there, and then after collection, we are transforming them with the different processes. This may be a chemical process followed by decomposition, and then this may be adopted by the environment, and then this is recycling. On the contrary, if we talk about the reversible process, material of parts of manufacturing, then they can be recycled. They can not be recycled, then they can be reused or reproduced, and then retail services, and then they are collection. So this is the entire process in the environmental system, followed by the collection, reuse, revise, and rejuvenation of the same. Otherwise, it will be very difficult task to maintain the such waste, because collection of the waste is equally very important as far as the environmental sustainability or eco-friendly practices are concerned. So what is the solution? The fundamentals of WTE, that is waste to energy, there are three good solutions, that is called 3 R's concept, and that is reduce. First of all, we need to reduce the usage, or we need to reuse the same, and then we need to recycle. So these are in a circular economy very important. Let us talk about what do we mean by reducing. Reducing, a first priority in waste management must be an overall function of solid waste quantities. Examination, GOSIA or example, that may be called as food waste, packaging, unnecessary waste or raw materials and energy during production process. Reducing waste also reduces the cost of waste collection and treatment. Now, once we are talking about why to reduce, first of all, we need to understand the importance of the reduction. Reduction is, once we are reducing the waste, then the cost of collection of the waste and its treatment will always be squeezed, or the financial burden, or the scientific and social burden. Let's say the waste is available in environment, it will be collected, it's okay, it will be recycle and rejuvenate or reuse, it's okay. But if it is damped to condensed to the environment, definitely it will create certain pollutant, and if not, it is going to harm the environment or nature as a whole. Reuse is a second priority should be given to the reuse of materials, that is, a discharged product is cleaned and repaired to be used again. Most of the time, the recycling process or reuse process is, or recycling process followed by the reuses of the product is on priority by the company, while whenever they are disposing certain goods or elements, they are using it. Recycling is the third priority of the 3 R's concept to recycle material, that is to collect waste and to transform it into as economy raw material. Anything or everything can be reused, but in practically we need to understand, or we need to have a scientific understand by the name of knowledge segment generation, what can be recycled and how can be recycled and where it can be used. Recycling of plastic, example of plastic or proper or paper, can normally save more energy in the production of products than the energy that can be produced in waste to energy plants for these materials. So waste and energy conversion, or waste to energy production, is one more way. Otherwise, there are 3 R system, that is called recycle, followed by reusing, followed by reducing. So this is one of the important parameter that we need to follow. Now we'll talk about myths around waste to energy. I will quickly follow the points. Energy recovery from MSW, that is municipal waste, has a role in the circular economy when used to non-recyclable and hazardous waste fraction, respecting environmental standards and carefully considering social aspects. However, it is in integration in the developing and emerging countries is still in the initial stages. Responsible options may be offered by some firms. However, many discussions on the topic can be biased and the non-transparent. So one of the myths is related to the waste to energy, that is MSW, that is the municipal waste, has a role in circular economy. It has got the role, but there are a lot more processes into it, and it may be sometimes hazardous waste fraction. It may also be respecting environmental standards and carefully considering social aspects. Next is, it is to integrate in developing and emerging countries. Many other time it has been opt as a myth that this is going to integrate with the development of the countries. Though it is developed, or it will help the countries for the development of theirs, but it is having their different other sides also. It is important to be aware of several common myths that the persist around waste to energy and may be pushed to inexperienced companies to take advantage of municipalities. Myths are, waste to energy is an easy going solution to get rid of all waste problems in a city. Many of the time we used to understand all wastes are convertible to the energy, and that will be the entire problem of our waste. This is the myth. This is not a fact. The myth number two is WTE, waste to energy plant, can finance its cost exclusively through the sale of recovered energy. Where we thought that whatever the energy will transform or we create through that particular waste, it will come up with the price of that particular plant or financing price, which is also a myth, because comparison of the investment output of the waste may not be such good some or the other time. Myth number three, with a WTE plant in operation, a big fraction of the energy demand of a city can be covered. That is, waste to energy plant is operation, a big fraction of energy demand of a city can be covered. Many other time we used to think that if we are having one such plant in our city, it will complete all our energy requirement. That is not true, because it's a huge proportion. Once we are talking about the waste, a lot of waste are required to be transformed from the waste to the energy. Then you can make gold from garbage. It's a myth. Gold can be created through the garbage. Even unstored waste can be sold with profit to be used for the further energy and material recovery, but it's not that much in proportion. So it is not adequate, and it is a myth. Myth number five, qualified and experienced international companies are going up to invest and operate large WTE, that is waste to energy plants, in developing and emerging countries at their own risk. So it's a fact, but it is not the reality. But we consider that there are many companies, they are working on that. The reality is different. So these are the certain myths. Precondition for waste to energy. Now this is probably the last slide that we are talking about for energy and to waste management. Energy and waste management precondition is that whenever we are talking about waste management, followed by converting it into the energy while managing energy requirement of the city or country. One is planning and tendering. The one of the most difficult phase is planning and tendering such things, because to plan certain land, to plan have in terms of its architectural dimension, its outcomes, the propagation, engineering design, or certain other things are very complex in nature. And then to tender, because there are lack of expertise in that particular area. Next is obligation of operators. The operators are showing that there are less obligation for operational work throughout the years, because they are not consistent with their operational obligatory aspect. That is not a good aspect, and then that, therefore it may be called up as a great amount of challenge. Prerequisite for permitting, there are many things to be talked about in terms of permit. Then there are a lot of great groundwork needs to be covered initially. Safety and environmental standards needs to be followed by the organization and the countries, so that the hazard may not be created. So this is very difficult phenomena. Monitoring of the compliance and the safety of the environmental standard is one of the important ingredients. So in our discussion, we are proceeding towards the last topic, that is called principle of sustainable tourism or sustainable tourism development. So let us talk. In syllabus, it has been called up as tourism development. So first, we need to understand what is first sustainable tourism development. Sustainable tourism development meets the needs of present tourists and host regions while protecting and enhancing opportunities for the future. That meant for sustainable tourism development practices are certain practices which are meeting the need of present tourists and qualifying for hosting the region for the future opportunities. It is investigated as the leading to the management of all source resources in such a way that economic, social, and then the aesthetic needs can be fulfilled while maintaining cultural integrity, essential ecological process, and biological diversity and life support system. So this is the definition of sustainable tourism development or sustainable development through tourism. Been given by United Nations World Tourism Organization in 1998. So let us talk this definition with more stretch. Sustainable tourism development meets the need of tourists and host regions while protecting and enhancing opportunity for the future. So anything or everything as a practice of sustainability, especially in emphasis of tourism, as a practice which is ensuring our future while protecting our present, or we can say we are adopting such practices so that the resources can be available for the future. While doing this, we will manage all the resources in such a way that economic, social, and aesthetic needs can be fulfilled. On the other hand, we will maintain the integrity, especially in ecological, biological, and life support system in terms of cultural integration. So this is what the sustainability in terms of the tourism or sustainable development in terms of tourism. In other words, sustainable tourism development is ecological, sustainable, economical, viable, and as well as ethically social. So anything or everything is called as sustainability that needs to be three areas to be covered: environment, economy, and society. Environment, economy, and then society. So all three areas can only be ensured once sustainable tourism development is ecologically sustainable, where when we are ensuring the interest for the ecology first, then its economical viability and ethical practices, followed by social equity. So this is the trio of all three, that is called the environment, that is called the economy, and that is called the society. So this is what the parallels of sustainable development. It respects the fragile environment, balance that characterize many tourism destinations, particularly in environmentally sensitive areas. And that is, now we'll talk about sustainable tourism is characteristics by enhancing the well-being of communities. First of all, anything can be, or everything that can be called up as sustainable tourism practices, once they are ensuring the well-being of local communities, because ultimately it is the local that needs to be benefited. Next is supporting the protection of the cultural and the cultural environment, natural and cultural environment, because if without providing protection to the culture and nature, we really cannot protect the sustainability or ensure the sustainability. Then it is to recognize product quality and tourist satisfaction. It is essential. Applying adaptive management and monitoring for this particular practice. So by the help of today's video, we have completed the topic called, first is eco-friendly practices. It may be called up as environment friendly or eco-friendly practices, both are same. And then we have talked about waste and energy management or energy requirement or waste management. And lastly, we had also talked about the concept of sustainable tourism development. So with this, before I shall say good night or conclude, I would like to request kindly go through these videos properly. These are the significant classroom presumptions completed by me as a teacher, and these are complete capsule course of the course which is being given by the university or the institute. So I will request, keep yourself healthy mentally, physically, stay at home, enjoy yourself, do watch and do learn. Till then, from my side, it's good night. Thank you so much.